Welcome to FinTech Chatter, brought to you by Tier 1 People, leaders in FinTech executive search. I'm your host, Dexter Cousins. I'm joined by the godfather of FinTech, Brett King.
Well, Brett, welcome to a very special episode, episode 100. Great to have you back.
I'm delighted to be here, Dexter.
So you've written many books on banking and fintech. What was it that got you to or made you kind of change the focus and go a lot broader?
I feel I'm a futurist. And my job is really to help people prepare for that future. Now, obviously, I've invested a ton of time in the banking space because I have domain expertise there. But I think it was also time I felt like I'd had a pretty good shot over the last 10, 11 years in terms of, transforming the banking space and making people aware of the issues in that. Mm. And I thought it was time for me to tackle something a bit meatier, something a bit more meaningful for the planet and for the species.
Yeah. It's very, very thoroughly researched. Where did you go for the research?
I did all the research myself. We started with various theses. I mean, how the book actually started is Richard and I got in a room in Sydney, actually, with a whiteboard and just mapped out some of the core issues. Mm-hmm. And one of the core ways of sort of framing this is, what are the potential future states of mankind? Because this book really looks, it's a book about philosophy of the human species, really. But we look at socio-political, socio-economic organizing principles. How do we organize society today? How does society function, from a social cohesion perspective, economics perspective, and so forth? And where does the current problems that we see in these future crises lead us? And so we had to sort of try and find a way to frame that. And ultimately, what we came up with on the whiteboard that day was, one of the biggest problems today we face is inequality. And the pandemic accentuated inequality. So how do we solve inequality? So one of the axes is inclusion or collectivism, right? And so you have on the top of the axis, inclusion, inclusive societies, collective policy, et cetera. And on the other end of the spectrum, you have exclusionary economies and very individualistic societies, so where individualism is valued over the whole. And then on the other axis of this four-quadrant sort of future, we have planned positive outcomes and chaotic planned utopian, chaotic dystopian. Yeah. And so we then fitted four models into that we saw as likely and what would be the key drivers for that. And from there then started to research each of those specific elements where, for example, what paradigms or templates do we have based on historical events, previous analogies, what we've seen in terms of human behavior in the past, and how will that apply to the future, and where we need to change that in respect to producing the most optimal outcome for humanity as a species, the planet as a whole.